Ona voli moje dredove, voli moje Nike, voli moje headove, mirišu ko iz bajke. Voli sve što kažem, voli kako nosim stvari, voli moje tetovaže, ona voli sve što radim. Ona voli moje dredove, voli moje Nike, voli moje headove, mirišu ko iz bajke. Voli sve što...
Ej, dobrodošli u demo. Vo 13 epizoda vo GTA Vice City. Pa ajde krenu sam mi sad taksis.
Car 13, we got a missed car test. Ask for you especially.
Okay, I got it. Car 13, out.
Who likes golf and laughing and photo opportunities at your store or place of business? Just send me a letter. I'll send you an automated photocopied response. We call it democracy. You, Shorty, shut up and let me speak. I'm taller than him, ladies and gentlemen, by at least 3 inches, which means I'm a lot more respectable looking. Everyone knows politicians lie and steal and cheat, but at least with me in charge, you know I look good and I have a very supercilious manner. Besides which, I've been abroad and I prefer it here because I'm a man of the people. Vote Shrub. You'll get richer and you won't feel guilty about it.
That's
the question. I'm a professional. That's my job.
And Mr. Hickory, what about you?
All right. These problems are typical of what happens with an open border to the north. The state is filling up with trash. People who can't tell the difference between a swamp and a marsh. Guys who don't know the first thing about the legality of marrying within the family. That's why we need a river. People, I'm telling you, pick up your spades, go into your garden, start digging as deep and as far as you can. Pretty soon the whole state will be flooded and ruined, and then they'll have to leave. We must build a moat to the north or they will come down and ruin this great state.
And Mr. Hickory, looks like a Mercedes.
What a stupid question of all the cheek.
Were you?
Of course not. No one's been born in Florida since 1877, but I've been here for 5 years, which is a very long time.
Yes, it is. A very long time. Almost as long as this show. Ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to Pressing Issues with me, Maurice Chavez, presiding over some of the least informed debate on the radio. In this episode of Pressing the Issue, we had Alex Shrub, Callum Crayshaw, and John Florida Hickory discussing safety. I guess you've all... Please, gentlemen...
Fuck! Fuck!
And let me speak. I'm taller than him, ladies and gentlemen, by at least 3 inches, which means I'm a lot more respectable looking. Everyone knows politicians lie and steal and cheat.
No sign of Mercedes.
I look good and I have a very supercilious manner. Besides which, I've been abroad and I prefer it here because I'm a man of the people. Vote Shrub. You'll get richer, and you won't feel guilty about it.
Enough! We're running out of time, and you completely failed to answer the question.
I'm a professional. That's my job.
And Mr. Hickory, what about you?
All right. These problems are typical of what happens with an open border to the north. The state is filling up with trash. People who can't tell the difference between a swamp... marrying within the family. That's why we need a river. People, I'm telling you, pick up your spades, go into your garden, start digging as deep and as far as you can. Pretty soon the whole state will be flooded and ruined, and then they'll have to leave. We must build a moat to the north or they will come down and ruin this great state.
And Mr. Hickory, were you born in Florida?
What a stupid question of all the cheek.
Were you?
It's time for Kaufman's cab, Guardian Angel, to eat some fender.
I've been here for 5 years, which is a very long time.
Yes, it is. A very long time. Almost as long as this show. Ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to Pressing Issues with me, Maurice Chavez, presiding over some of the least informed debate on the radio. In this...
Hey, And hey, can we swim with? Petit dark. Essa era com estilo no novo mesmo que saia um tchau pai ele bem te matar bem gosta te mal vou pisar te mal tá é esse estilo no meu chamado tá é velho do lado se dum do estilo do lado o tá fac não me engano está só o estilo ideal dessa se dum do estilo agora com que está É, da hora. Três boas. Vamos dar pra você. É, deve. É. Muito dias. Vocês já tinham me açúcar, né, meu bebê? Ah, que me mexe. Você tá. E com isso. Vê cá. Print works. Print. Na página, não. Sprint, né? Bela.
Mr. Vassetti? Hey, you bought the old print works?
Yeah, my old man used to work on these. I used to spend the evenings with him cleaning the rollers. I was gonna follow him in his trade, but... I lived a different life.
You planning on selling the old machinery? Breaking it down?
I'm thinking we might print something. A newspaper, a magazine.
Oh, crap, Sonny. Low-grade crap. I've always fancied printing money. It ain't too hard. You know, I've been doing it on a small scale for years.
Really?
Sure. But we need some good quality plates. Of course. There's a counterfeiting syndicate already operating in Florida.
A syndicate?
Yeah, well, just rumors is all I've heard.
I know a man who's good with rumors.
That's how much of taxi is this catch him up?
Relax.
You bait her out here again.
The Buddhist did it.
Eu
gosto
de...
Oh. Ah, dá o problema. Ah, ai.
É...
Qual que é, meu? Vou lá, acho que é...
Look at the ass on that. All right, girls, you're lost, mate, innit? All right, me old China! How's it hanging?
What do you know about counterfeiting?
Oh, I'm fine, Paul. How about you?
Come here!
Oh, all right. You obviously a busy man. All I know about Dodgy Reddy's is to try and supply the plates. Ah!
Fuck! You know,
they've got a shipping company down the docks. The boss man would know when the plates are coming in next.
Thanks, Paul.
What's the matter with you, you maniac?
Maniac.
You need another drink, lively.
Whoa there, young whippersnapper!
Rightly. Have you been to the zoo? Animals are naked. If everyone were naked, there'd be no war. Everyone's complaining about crime and the theft of cars in the city. No one's ever stolen my car. No one's ever pickpocketed me. They've never even tried.
That's because you're a degenerate loony.
If the police were naked, it would set a great example to everyone. You can direct traffic and eat donuts entirely in the bus.
Like some bizarre,
Maurice, this kind of immoral behavior is exactly why I'm building the Pastor Richard Salvation statue. Noah had an ark, Texans had the Alamo, and I am building a highly fortified structure in my image. This 50-story statue will be able to deflect alpha, gamma, and beta radiation. The day is coming and coming soon where the artificial suns will rain down to punish the degenerates of this city. But you can see the Pastor Richard's Salvation statue will be a completely self-sufficient community. We have canned food rations, private living quarters, and enough supplies to survive happily.
Check it out, come on.
Hey, baby, you just found
again. What a song!
Nah, what's that? Well, but, Olha, tá, moleque, meu, esse, tá? Putz, eu não tô com nada. Nah, fuck. How the fuck? Se vidimo ko stignemo tu, gusto magua pizdare mata. Se vidimo.
Oh, I not the face, not the face. Oh, I talk.
Yeah, but God is handle tuka.
Super about that place. Now, kids these days don't know how to preserve and can their own food. No wonder all they want to do is play video games or hang out with their friends. What is it, the Degeneratron? What a crock of shit!
Hey, watch your language. This is radio. We have regulations about that sort of thing.
But you let a naked man on.
Ah, he's behind the screen. You can't...
Alright, the courier's moving the plate from the docks today. I'm gonna go intercept them, grab the plates, lose any heat, and make my way back here. Now, depending how well this goes, we may have 5 minutes to print the money before the counterfeit syndicate finds us, or we may have all year. Either way, I want green rolling off the presses 5 minutes after I get back. Got it?
Don't you worry, Tommy. We'll be ready.
Me and the boys will be around in the neighborhood in case you need any heat taken care of.
Alright, everybody cool? Alright, I'll catch you later.
Relax!
What the f-
So anyway, as I was saying, this early girl in the nightclub, you know. Now, of course, I turned out the money. Did not come home with me.
Before we hear about any more criminal acts against government employees, you're listening to Pressing Issues. Morality is the subject at hand. Let's explain exactly how free radio without commercial breaks works. We'll be right back.
You're listening to VCPR. Finally, a radio station for teachers and librarians. You've been enjoying Pressing Issues, but as is normal, you can't listen to an hour's worth of programming on this station without us begging for money. It's the bi-daily begathon.
Vediamo.
Hey, hello, Tommy, we got a situation over at Printworks. You better go and check it out.
Oh, yeah.
Wow, some kind of mess or other. Things are messed up. I gotta go.
Rosenberg. Yeah. And then we said, okay. It's a petty mission.
Okay, what's the emergency?
Something out there.
Tommy, some mob thugs said they'd come to take their cut. Said it was a Mr. Farello's money. Oh, I feel like crap.
Farelli? Sonny Farelli?
Yeah, that's the guy. I think. They were very insistent.
I'm not angry with you. Get him to the hospital.
Tommy, rip that guy a new asshole for me.
I'm gonna rip him too!
In France, question the morality of making the mammoth extinct. I think we all...
This girl's a real tiger, man.
Oye!
Oh,
butcher. My city is mine now, not his! You're good.
Including best voice. On this show, we take complex issues and boil them down to simple ones so you can understand. On this segment of the show, we are discussing morality. Since the beginning of time, man has asked questions. Why are we here? What time is it? And is there a place around here a guy can get a drink? Early man, as seen in the cave of Lascaux in France, questioned the morality of making the mammoth extinct. I think we all know what happened there. Is it society's job to tell each other how to live? Recently, my city considered passing a public curfew that says nobody can be on the streets after 8:30 p.m. Of course, the bill didn't get passed. Is that
the Harwood Butcher? You're gonna die for city.
You'll lose.
No, we've worked through it. He was stressed. It's hard keeping a family together these days.
Everyone, take your clothes off and feel what it's like to be free of bondage. Everyone out there in Vice City, take your clothes off. If this is the land of the free, let's start with our pads. Feel the wind from the air conditioning. Ugh, a breeze is so liberating.
Thanks very much. Now, if you could get back behind that divider, Barry, please. Otherwise, I'm going to have to ask you to leave. Thank you. Now sit down. On pressing issues, we think it is very important to respect one another. To treat each other like...
Son, why don't you move to Russia? I don't understand people in America today. They call this a cold war, but it's hotter than hell. Mark my words, any day now you're sitting in school, passing notes and talking about the prom, when suddenly you look out the window and there are Russian paratroopers dropping in to take over. What can you do? Run into the woods with your friends? Call yourselves the Wolverines? Put twigs in your hand? Try to beat back the Ruskies? No, you hightail it to Pastor Richard's Salvation statue and blast off into space. But there is a limited amount of space. That's why I suggest anyone who wants the safety and security of your own bunker, give now. Call 866-9-SAVE-ME. We'll get you on the payment plan, and if you're paid in full on D-Day, you and your family will be safe. If not, you may have to choose to save yourself and leave the others behind.
Hey, stop selling things on my show. You're not a valued sponsor who supports the art of public radio, buddy.
I, for one, welcome our new Russian masters. We could... with guilt. As a matter of fact, I don't let my kids watch cartoons or slasher flicks.
Really?
That Knife After Dark movie may be number one in the box office, but my kids certainly ain't gonna see it. If you don't raise your kids right, they end up being like New Boy over there or working in radio. I want them to get proper jobs, like being a doctor, not a patient.
That is offensive. My mother understood I was special. She made me wear a bonnet as a child, and when I demanded to go to school naked, she was fine with it. After social services moved me, she would still write to me. I still remember when she kissed me goodbye.
But Barry, earlier you said you discovered naturism, taking your clothes off, whatever it is in German.
I know, but I lie a lot. I've got a lot of personal issues. Look at me. Please, Maurice, I need a hug.
There's another example of immorality in this city. Public showing of affection. People think we want to see the making out and carrying on. I understand your hormones. We're building a statue and we need your help. Call me now.
You know, pretty soon you won't be able to tell who's a human and who's an android. Why, the corporation is working on it right now. I know. I read about it. I tell my kids not to kiss other kids at school. It might be an android. Suck your brains out. You must have seen the miniseries event on television. I read it in a book. We've got to stop looking at the stars, all this science fiction, and focus on the family. Now, if you really want to dance like you're on the moon, go there and leave us in peace. And that's a fact.
What's a fact?
I'm sorry, Maurice, but I have...
Tommy, I had Sonny on the phone, okay? Are you with me? I don't know about you, but there's something about a man threatening to murder my family which really scares the crap out of me. What are you gonna do?
Ken, take it easy.
I am calm. Calm as a man can be when he's fearing for his life.
Stay off the idiot fuel and look after yourself. No one's gonna take us out. I'll see you later.
I am calm. Don't I sound calm? Must be impending death that is doing this to my voice.
Hey, it's Mr. V.
Tommy, it's Lance. We got big problems. Come down here right away.
Tommy!